Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing with you my favorite winter snack time dish recipe, which is methi masala puri. So let's get started. So the ingredients we need are 1 cup of whole wheat flour, 1/4 cup of suji, 2 tablespoons of kasuri methi, and if you are using fresh methi, 1 cup of fresh methi, 1/2 tablespoon of turmeric powder, salt according to your taste, 1/2 tablespoon of sugar, 1 tablespoon of ginger paste, 1 tablespoon of green chili paste, 1/2 tablespoon of cumin seeds, that is jeera, 2 tablespoon of oil, and lastly warm water to knead the dough. First we have to prepare the dough, and for that we'll take a big plate or parath and add 1 cup of whole wheat flour, 1/4 cup of suji, salt, 1/2 tablespoon of regular sugar, 1/2 tablespoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 tablespoon of cumin seeds, and mix all the ingredients well. After mixing all the ingredients, now we will add 1 tablespoon of ginger paste, green chili paste, 2 tablespoon of kasuri methi, or if you are using fresh methi, then 1 cup quantity. Next we'll add 2 tablespoon of oil. Mix all the ingredients well with the help of warm water and knead the dough with semi-tight consistency. We are using warm water because it gives softness to the dough, but you can use normal water as well. Now the dough is ready, so we will cover it up with a fresh cloth and let it rest for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, remove the cloth. The dough looks well set, so we will knead it for a few seconds. Now take small portions of the dough out and roll them like a ball between palms and press them lightly. Repeat the same steps with all the dough. Now all the dough balls are ready, so we'll start rolling them. For that we'll take a dough ball out, sprinkle the dry flour on top and start rolling it like chapati. The dry flour will help it in not sticking to the rolling pin. After rolling the puri, now with the help of a knife, poke the puri so that it does not rise and get puffed up while frying, and you get a crispy puri. Repeat the same steps for making more puris. Sprinkle some dry flour and roll the dough ball like chapati. Keep the puris as thin as possible, or you can see the thickness I have kept here. Now with the help of a knife, poke the puri so that it doesn't get puffed up. Now we have rolled all the puris, so we'll start frying. The oil is hot enough and ready for frying. Keep the gas on medium flame and carefully drop the puris in hot oil. Lightly press the puris with frying ladle and fry them until they are golden brown, which will take around 2 to 3 minutes on each side. After frying for around 3 minutes, you can see that the puri is golden brown now. Drop the excess oil and take the puris out and repeat the same steps for making more puris. Carefully drop them in hot oil and keep frying them until they are turned little golden brown. All the crispy puris are fried and ready. You can enjoy them at a snack time or tea time, and these can last up to 3 days. That's all for today guys. If you want me to do more snack time videos, you can comment me below, or you can also share your pictures and feedback on my Facebook and Twitter page. Thank you guys for watching, and do subscribe.